Okay, I got my workstation set up on my drawn tablet here with my drawn tablet glove. It looks very camp, but stops the screen from scratching. Anyway, this drawing in front of me now is an illustration I did a few months ago, maybe half a year ago. And it was very much an ayahuasca experience inspired painting. And when I did this, I did it on many multiple layers, and I want to try and go back now and add a little bit of animation to this painting. So on the right here of the screen, I have all my layers here, and they're all sort of divided into folders. The main bulk of the painting is on one layer itself, and if I just switch on this black layer here, you'll see these are the sort of the foreground elements that separate the elements I want to animate from the painted background itself. So we have some of these spiral elements. So I want to try and animate these little blue orbs. I'll have them kind of floating up in the screen. And I can probably add some glowing effects to make them sort of radiate and pulse light. I think I'll do that as well. What else do we have? So we have this main light, which is guiding this kid through the forest environment here. And I think what I'm going to try to do is animate each of these coming from this very colorful lady's mouth, which is her guiding voice that's guiding the kid through this forest. So we have the female head here. That looks very cool. Wow! I think I might change it to look like that instead. That is cool. I've never seen it like that. So I'm getting an idea here, but the only problem is this would take a very long time. Yeah, each of these yellow circles here is its own individual layer. I could, for instance, have the elements grow in and out, and that might just be a cool little element to add to it. But because I'd have to do it for each one, although I could do it for one and then just duplicate it around the face. So I think I might do that. So yeah, on the female head, there's quite a few elements I could play with. Yeah, these little purple guys, the sacred geometry, I could do some neat stuff with. I could do rotation animations for that. Just have that slowly rotating constantly and kind of moving and waddling, perhaps. Just something simple. There's not going to be any very complex animation to it. They're all going to be very simple, but when they're all simply animated together, then it has a nice effect to it. The picture as a whole will look good. The spirits here, I could have these glow elements go up and down in opacity to give a fluctuating glow effect. Yeah, that could work well. There's some sacred geometry in this background, in the celestial kingdom. So I can have that rotating in the back. It is going to look very, very trippy, but good. And so that's it. There's a few, there's certainly a few layers I could play with there. Okay, so I'm going to save out each of these layers. It's going to take a fair while. I'm not going to record that because it's just very boring to watch. And then I will bring them into After Effects here and do some animation. Luckily, on a previous project, I already did some animation with these blue orbs, and I can just apply them into this image, maybe tweak them a little, because in this there's quite a few of them. I'll just play them. It plays a bit slow because I haven't rendered them out, but Yeah, I can add this into it for sure. So I think what I did to actually animate this is I probably animated 5 or 6 alternative movements for the balls, and then just duplicated them, pushed them further back, made them smaller. So let's see if I select one of the orbs here. You can see its movement cycle. Where is it? It's hard to see this one here. Yeah. And I've applied a wobble to it, so it doesn't follow the path perfectly. You'll see they all kind of have a bit more of an organic wobble movement to it. So it's kind of like flower petals in the wind or something. This is the animation I put at the beginning of my showreel. So on this I think it shows it here as well. At the bottom of the screen it has all the different layers, and you can turn them on and off here. So I would animate each element, sort of rotating like that, and I put another element in, add some rotation, and they all have different speeds of rotation, so it looks just more interesting. If all the layers that are at the same rotation speed, then there's no point having them on different layers. Just add them all different rotation speeds, and it just makes it look interesting. So I'm not sure if I can put this in the painting. I might get away with doing this very faintly in the background. Have the layer blending mode set to overlay, which means it interacts with the layers behind it a bit more. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and save out the different layers on this, bring them all into that program After Effects, and I'll start recording again when I've reached that point in the process. Alright, catch you then. Alright, so I have my composition set up here. I'm going to try and keep it at 6 seconds to keep the file size low, and then I'm going to try and attempt to have all the animation loop, so when it plays, it's going to be like a looped animation when it goes back to the beginning. I'm going to try and make it seamless, so let's bring in the layers. So that's all the layers in right now. Some of the ones that are low in opacity, I'm only using those for guide reference, because I'm going to be animating the individual element and then duplicating it around. So let's get started with some of the animation then. I think I'll start with... Let's try and get the blue orbs in first, because they're the most difficult, I think. All right. But I've already done them. Pick one, this. This one. Okay, so there's the beginning and there's the end. I'm gonna make it go for the entire 6 seconds. And move the starting point here. So this is what the path will look like. Okay. Now, in order for it to loop, I'm going to have it start at a opacity 100. 100. I don't have a keyframe there at 100, then bring it down to 0 opacity and 0 opacity. So that it comes into appearance and disappears at the end. That way it can loop back and forth. Now what I'll do is I'll just duplicate it. Command D. Now I'm going to move that. Oh no. Go to the beginning. Move the starting one. Go to the end. Move the finishing one. And I think I want to do that pathway. Maybe make it. Duplicate it again. Come to the beginning. Move this way over here. And move the end one over here. So I'm adjusting the movement path here. Let's see, so there's three of them now. What I like about this one is there's some different colors, so I'm gonna get this one. Copy that. I often lock these layers because I can accidentally select them and animate the wrong way. I don't really want these balls, these orbs, even to interfere too much with the characters. See, this one up here interferes and gets in the way of the spirits, so I'm gonna move that. Yeah. I wanna try and keep the animated orbs just in the kind of the dead space. I don't wanna interfere in this key area. So there's a few. I don't want to overload it. I think I will add about half more. About twice as many as we have. Now I did already animate these, so I'm not cheating. I made these myself, so I'm just stealing from myself, which I don't mind myself doing. That looks good for the moment. A lot of them travel up very high, and I would like to add a few more that rise just very slightly up to this character's chin and then disappear before going any further. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna export this, see what it looks like when it's rendered, because when I play in this program, it plays all slow. Render it, see what it looks like. I think I'm gonna add more to it, but leave that phase for now, and then move on to the next one, because I don't wanna overload too much. I'll see what this looks like when I got all the other elements animated, and then if I think it still needs more, then I'll add a few more orbs to it, and if not, I won't. So let's take a look. So the animation is finished rendering, and this is how it looks. Pretty good. Only one thing that's wrong at the moment is this first orb that comes into existence here, this one I'm following.
When it first comes into existence, it's a bit too jarring. It appears too suddenly. And so when it loops back and forth, it's very, very obvious that it comes to. So I'm going to make that transition a bit more fluid. So I'm going to make a change to that and then proceed on to the next animated feature. Let's go. There's a cool effect called Wiggle. Wiggle-rama. No. Just wiggle position. I want you to wiggle your position. Then you go into the effects tab, go into amount. You want to change the variables a bit. I can't remember what was a good one to do. I think. That doesn't look good. It is you. What do you do? You turn the amount up. Maybe? I don't know. Oh my god. Too much. Wiggle speed 0.4. Just right, because I'm just going to duplicate it each time, more or less. I'll change a few of them. Something like that could work. Alright. Duplicate that. Let's move it. Some glows to what I've already animated. So, best thing to do is go to the effect panel, think of kind of what effect you want to do and see if it's there. So I click glow, and After Effects has some pretty neat glowing effects. Not as good as maybe what you can achieve in Photoshop, but still pretty good. Okay. Alright, let's take a look at all these different variables in the effects control panel. I guess I've given the impression to people that I know what I'm doing, but each time I work on something is me just experimenting. Around about this time I start to get excited because things start to take shape. One of the most valuable skills with this art is patience. Patience is all you need. Patience will develop skill and let you, or make you sit on your ass until you've done the work. That's the most important thing, to finish it. So me talking to the camera, doing this. This is actually very normal. I don't. I just. This is how I work when I'm not filming. I just talk to myself because it helps me figure out things. So, I don't know. This is gonna give someone a seizure, I think. I think so. Well, my cat is epileptic, so I can give it a test on her. She actually is, she's epileptic. And that goes to 2. It's so hard to see. When it gets this late into the game and there's so much movement on the screen, it's so hard to see what changes you're making to one individual layer. I'll keep going and just hope it's doing what I hope it's doing. bring this. Alright, so here's a render, let's see what it looks like. Please don't be horrible. Go. Oh, it's so quick. Why is it so fast? Oh, I don't know. There's one orb there that's way too big. It just goes right over the kid there. And it's really distracting. And this guy is way too quick. He's like, whoa, I'm coming onto the scene. Look at me. Actually, I kind of like him, he's funny. I think the blue orbs are going to be too distracting. They're only supposed to be there as a companion element. The main element has to be these patterns come from the lady's mouth. And at the moment, the orbs are just, whoa, too much. You can overkill things. The orbs are overkilling things. I think it's because they travel too high and just want them to travel a little distance. Like this blue one is just going crazy. This one on the left. Look at him go. Sacred patterns? Meh. Fine. They're fine. I'm gonna leave it for now. And work on the other elements and see how they go. And then once I see the other elements, I might tone down some of the other things, like the orbs especially. When they're on their own, they look good. But with the whole painting, it might be overkill. All right, let's go to the next part. I'm tired, it's late. Okay, let's go ahead and start on. I'm gonna do the woman. I mean, I'm gonna animate the woman. See what it looks like. That looks super neat. It's like color is fluctuating through her. Beautiful. Beautiful. Too much. got a render, so let's see what this looks like. Select loop. It's a bit of a low compression, but I get the idea. It is starting to look crazy. So what the bloom did is kind of set the background layer. It's put another version of the layer on top, and it's all different positions and scales. And it appears ever so faintly, but it looks like a damaged negative on a film or something. So I like it. I think the woman's face paint is the best thing about this. I'm gonna have to experiment with more things like this. The reason why it works so well is the face paint is on a layer on its own, so I can build up multiple layers of that. There's two layers of the face paint, and they each have glows at different speeds, so it's like, you see like color fluctuate through it. Nice happy accident, an unintended result. It's nice, apart from the orbs which need to be toned down. It's achieving my intended result, which is something very subtle, but definitely something there. Cool. I am gonna go ahead and animate the circles around the lady. Hey lady, I've come to animate your circles. I gotta be careful with this though, because it has the potential to be really chaotic. I'm gonna make the circles grow bigger and smaller, but it needs to happen in a way that's slightly uniform. They're not all randomly doing it at different speeds. Some kind of uniformity to it, a bit like Mexican wave or something, and I make it all start from the mouth, because that is where the main focus of the animation is from. So let's unlock this and move it here. God, this is gonna take a while. Okay. And in After Effects, it's just wades in for the program. You have to be very zen to work in this program. Little circles around her. Well, it's currently around her mouth. It's gonna look good when I repeat it. Okay, so I'm gonna continue on and duplicate this circle around. I actually want it to start instead by the pineal gland here. Thank you. wobble-tastic. The only thing is, it's not going to work very well on the loop, but whatever. A sacrifice, I think I'll take. Trying to get it to loop better so not everything has to disappear at the end. So I'm duplicating the layer, splitting it in half, and having the first half at the last half and the second half at the first half. I think it works. It works in my head. So it'll be an orb on this right side. Yeah, no, that didn't work. It kind of worked. What was the problem there? I have a feeling I've gone overboard with the glows, but I like glows. That last flash is a bit too much.
Okay, there's more or less just one more element that I'm looking to add. And I think I did this effect long ago on an old animation, and I'm not sure if I can remember where it was or how best to apply it. It was kind of like light streaks coming from the sun. It's like light beams, essentially. And I think I want to put them in the background in the celestial kingdom. So let me see where I might put this. Maybe on the background.
So that's rendering. Once that is done, it might take a while, so I'll stop recording now. Once that is done, I'm going to bring it into Adobe Premiere, add a little bit of color correction. Then it should be finished. Alright, catch you then. Okay, so this is the final animation. Just simple, 6 seconds long, low file size of 4 megabytes. I can probably make that a bit smaller. So I can have this play in immediately on the front page of my website. And but yeah, I mean, that wasn't the main reason why I made this. I wanted to try out this technique for a potential minimal style animation, slightly interactive, digital comic. I had the idea of, because of the story I want to make with my graphic novel, it's very animated. And I wanted to, in each of the comic book panels, or full pages, to have just a little, very minimal amounts of animation to give a suggestion of movement. I actually think in this one there is quite a lot of movement. I wasn't actually thinking of doing this much. I guess because this was the flagship test animation, I kind of went a bit overboard with all the different animated elements in this. But I like this technique. I've always found there's been some limiting factor in the paintings I do. As I said before, because I come from an animation background, just having still paintings just does not do it for me. I need to see some kind of animation. And I can do animation, so if I can do it, I may as well make use of it and put it into some paintings. So yeah, that is painting, or animating, the painted sacred forest. Thank you for your patience in viewing this all the way through. And yeah, I'll catch you next time. Thank you. Peace.